closed.
City leaders thought they had a done deal, but supporters of the Confederate monument refused to give up.
So get away from the black and white stuff.
4 months after a driver crashed into Reidsville's Confederate monument and toppled it, emotions still run high over what to do about it.
And if they tear this one down, are they going to go to the cemeteries where these memorials are at and allow them to take those monuments down too?
Monument supporters sent the city a letter threatening legal action if the Confederate soldiers' memorial isn't returned to downtown Reidsville, where it stood for more than 100 years.
If you have an accident, you fix it. You ain't break a window, fix it. Make it whole. And that's all we're asking for.
The group claims the state owns both the statue and the land where it stood. Is giving Reidsville leaders 30 days to respond or face a lawsuit.
So I was really taken aback the other day. I was actually disappointed that people thought that they had to, you know, form a political action committee. And
the community is divided over what to do about the monument, but not necessarily along racial lines.
You're an African American. There was a statue that honored the Confederacy, which supported slavery. No problem with you on that.
That's history.
While some African-American residents want the Confederate monument returned to its original spot, some white residents want it moved out of downtown.
Change is a difficult thing for a lot of people, but maybe it is time to change and take it, move it out there.
The battle over Reidsville's Confederate history rages on. Barbara Golding wrote a poem about the lost monument. She calls it the, quote, naked corner.
I drove by today. It left me feeling empty. A part of my heritage broken.
Both sides say they don't know, but this issue is far from over. In Reidsville, Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.